This is about the 12th iteration of Silver Room. I mean, most of the designs that we did were not really designed properly, honestly. It was kind of me just putting something together, you know, and kind of making it work, you know, and, you know, maybe 4 or 5 years later you change something up and every season you change. But this was the first time we actually sat down with a game plan, thinking about behavioral science, who's moving this way, flow of traffic.
I think our job was helping make this space really be a quiet backdrop for the products, changing the ceilings. It's now a kind of monolithic solid color. There's new pops of accent lighting, which I think shape and kind of elongate the space and bring you into the back. There's a new kind of reflective shiny floor that's both really resilient and easy to clean, but it's also, I think, a really good kind of backdrop for the millwork and the products. For me, what's most important is to like work with people we have connections with, and then the size of the project or the type of the project shouldn't matter. We always said when we started the practice, we were gonna try to work with people who are making change in their own fields.
And then Norman Teague, been working with Norman for, you know, 10 years on pop-up projects, on the old store, on furniture designs. So we've been talking about doing stuff together also. So Norman and Ann and Craig got together to come up with the design.
A lot of the shelving here is really flexible, so it can be moved depending on the merchandise that comes in. Tables, we know that at times this is a partyscape, this is a theater, so everything is kind of on wheels to offer that flexibility of really changing up the space for church on Sundays and storytelling on Thursdays. And then really giving a place for the merchandise to be so that it could have its own light as well, because let's face it, sales are really a key component to keeping the Silver Room alive.
And I got my man Gravity right here from way back from the Clinton administration. You know what I mean? Still doing the electrical work.
Everybody knows me as Gravity. I am assisting with the light install at the Silver Room. This project is the grand reopening after the grand global reset. So I think it's gonna be absolutely awesome. Silver Room's always been, you know, like a dope neighborhood community staple, even when it was on the north side. It's always been like an aesthetic staple too. It kind of sets the tone for the neighborhood it exists in.
Yeah, so I think one thing that kind of were my babies along the way was the shelving unit. Making something that was easy to put together, but then also like commanded the space as well. So making sure that, you know, it fit enough merchandise, it was big and sturdy. And then also this peg system, being able to, you know, put these different modular pieces on here. Being able to even hang up a shirt or a hat on these peg systems is really nice. So yeah, really proud of those things.
Man, it's ever evolving. You know, it's 22 years in, and it's been fun for me because it hasn't been stagnant, you know? I mean, inherently, it's a retail store, is what it is, but it's much more than that. It's a community space, it's a gathering space, it's a place for book signings, it's a dance floor, it's a place for fashion shows. So I like the fact that it's a lot of different things. And the more people discover it, the more things it can become. So for me, I look at it as we just kind of create a platform and people who come in can create what they want to from it.
I'm sure it will change as more hands get involved. You know, the Silver Room is such a cultural place and there's so many different minds, bodies, and souls that will put an additional touch to what we've done. So we've just laid down canvas that will allow for other people to come in and be a part of this.
For me, aesthetically, it was important to have something that was well-designed on the south side, you know? And I love going into boutiques around the world. Whenever I travel, I get off the plane, I go to the area to have like the really cool boutiques. You know, from Shibuya to, you know, Bangkok to, I mean, Mexico City, wherever I'm at, I really, really love small retail spaces. So I've kind of just really seen some spaces. I'm like, man, I would love to have my space be one of these spaces that people will come and look at, not just for the items, but also for the design of the space. So for me, that was really important. And I'm happy that I think we got something.
I am the only Dunzilla Killer Illmatic Static Thriller, big time player, honcho, boss, willy champion. Never ever lost one, never. And I spit the game clever. You already know that, player. I really got to use
to keep on.